How do I find good local computer help? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. And boy, do I wish I had an answer for this question, especially local to me. As you might imagine, many times I run into problems with my machines and I end up fixing them myself because I can. But I know that that's not the case for everybody. And rather than trying to basically spread myself way too thin helping friends and family that are local to me, I would love to be able to point people at someone else, a company, a business, a local computer repair solution that basically I could trust to deal with the problem in an ethical and cost-effective way. Good help is really hard to find, and that's never ever been truer than it is when it comes to computer repair. So what I'll describe here, I realize that this is a problem everywhere, not just local to me. In fact, if anything, it's probably more of a problem elsewhere since I live in a fairly tech dense area. So what I want to do is I want to go over some of the things to at least consider, some of the straws, if you will, to grasp at, to see if you can find someone who can help you if you're finding yourself in a situation where you need some computer repair, some computer help. It ultimately all comes back to reputation. There are good people, there are bad people. There are people that really understand what they're doing. There are people that cost a lot. There are people that cost a little. There are friends, there are family, there are services. But it really all comes back to reputation. Any of those characteristics that I just listed off, they could be good or bad. They could be out to get you. They could be out to scam you for your money, or they could be out to honestly add value. And I do believe that there are a lot of services, individuals, and scenarios where they're truly interested in helping you, in solving the issues that you're coming across. So it really all does come back to, what's their reputation like? How do you find someone's reputation in a situation like this? I would start by looking for local advice. By that, I mean doing things like asking your friends that have computers what they do, where they go, if they have someone to recommend, or if they have experience with some of the options in your area. Look for local computer help groups. Often libraries and senior centers in particular have something that is often completely free, if not inexpensive, and geared towards helping people that don't have resources to get help elsewhere. If they have classes, if they have opportunities, you have an opportunity to get in there and attend a few classes and figure out if these are people that you are comfortable with getting assistance from. And as always, ask around, right? If somebody you know has used the services of a local senior center or a local library, see if they've had a good experience. Go to a local computer store, and I say this specifically for computer stores that don't have their own repair option. I realize that this is sometimes hard to find, and sometimes you won't know until you go in there to find out that they have their own local repair. But if they don't have their own repair, then they're going to have somebody to point you at. They're going to have recommendations for where you can take your computers or software for assistance. Check out those recommendations and see if they might possibly fit for you. If they do have their own repair and support services, that's great. Don't just sign up, but once again, drop back. See if you can find out some information, some references, some history, some of the experiences other people have had with that specific company. This is one of those cases where a tool like Yelp might actually turn out to be helpful. Yelp, we often think of as being specifically for restaurants, but in reality, they often will have reviews and other information about other things, things other than restaurants, including computer repair. Like anything, especially in the restaurant scenario, Yelp can be gamed. We know that. But it's data, and it's data you can read and evaluate for yourself and decide whether or not the balance of the information that's being presented there is worth trusting, is worth believing. The same is true for just Google reviews. If you do a search for a local repair shop, either generically for computer repair in your location, or if you have the name of a local repair shop and you Google that, very often Google will present you with also some sets of reviews that people have left on google.com. That's another source of information. Same caveat, of course it can be gamed, but it's data that you can use to hopefully make a slightly more informed decision. Now, one of the questions that I often get is, what about the chains? A lot of these large nationwide or worldwide computer chains offer support. And honestly, it's a coin toss. My experience from what I've heard from people is simply that it's a coin toss. Some of them are really good. Some of them will do what you want and nothing more, and actually charge a reasonable price for it. Others, not so much. And I think it also has a tendency to change over time, because often these large chains have some turnover in their staff, and ultimately it's the staff that makes the difference as to whether or not it's going to be a legitimate operation or not. So once again, it's something to look at, but I would, if at all possible, see if you can find any source of reviews or references or independent local information that would allow you to at least make a slightly educated decision before deciding whether or not to use one of these services. So what I do, like I said, I'm not your typical computer user. 99 times out of 100, I'll deal with it myself. I'll order parts, I'll repair my machine, I'll get a new machine. If I've got a problem, especially if it's under warranty, then I will make extensive use of the computer manufacturer's resources. And that's something you should probably do anyway, just because it'll give you a sense for what kind of a problem you're looking at, so that you can kind of determine if that local person is feeding you a line or not. But using the computer manufacturer's resources as much as is possible to potentially be able to resolve issues yourself, well, that's my approach. I do want to talk a little bit about cost, because this is a problem for a lot of people. I get that. I mentioned earlier that sometimes places like senior centers and libraries offer some kind of resource for this thing, and very often those resources are free. Avail yourself of those if that makes sense. But realize that for businesses, it's their business, right? They're trying to make a living. They have to charge for their services in order to put food on their own table. And often it's a not insignificant charge, because often what we're asking for in terms of repair is a not insignificant amount of their time and their expertise and potentially parts. So be careful. It's worth remembering that good support is worth the money. Really, it's cheaper in the long run to have something fixed correctly with assistance than it is to have to deal with something over and over and over again because the first guy didn't get it right. On the other hand, sometimes repairs can be so expensive that it might be better to cut your losses and consider a replacement scenario. I hate doing that. I really hate doing that, because I really hate discarding good hardware because repairing it is going to be more expensive than replacing it. I try and avoid that wherever possible. And if you find yourself in that situation, I understand. I mean, money is a big issue, and paying for repairs can be very costly. Sometimes it really is cheaper just to replace the machine. If you find yourself in that situation, then at least see if you can't find a way to recycle, repurpose, donate that hardware to an organization that may have the aptitude to repair it themselves, and then maybe turn around and sell it so that they make some money, or use it so that they don't have to spend money on new software or new computers. So that's kind of the options that I'm aware of. That's kind of what I understand is a very, very difficult situation. It's very difficult for me to answer. Like I said, I don't even have an answer for locally here, other than, like I said, the local computer, the local senior center or the library. But I'd love to hear if you have other experiences, if you have good advice for people that are looking for reliable, trustworthy, cost-effective, local computer repair and support. For updates, for related links, for any of the comments and recommendations that some of our readers might leave, visit askleo.com/25661. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.